Let's talk about berberine for a minute. It comes from a plant, the barberry plant. Some technical names, rhizoma coptatus, berberisum amerindii. It's a good plant in terms of supplements and use for especially diabetes. Some say for cholesterol as well. We'll talk about that in just a few minutes. It was originally used in the East for bacterial diarrhea. It was noticed in the late 1900s that when using it for bacterial diarrhea, it often resulted in decrease in blood sugar. So they started saying, look, is this actually something that we can use instead of metformin? Talk a little bit more about the plantsman's perspective. Again, berberine, berberis, golden seal, Chinese golden seal, philodendron, bloodroot, several different names for this. In fact, like I said, 23 genera. Again, while we're on the technical side, what is it that's in there that's doing isoquinolone alkaloid? Again, just for the technical people and the biochemists. Here's what it looks like. You get red berries, and as you may see there, there's some thorns on it as well. One of them said, commented on a metformin video. We were doing a video talking about how to tolerate metformin, and he said, use berberine instead. It has similar benefits, but it's not tainted by association with standard doctoring. A friend of mine is prescribed metformin, but uses this, golden seal, golden milk. Tom Deck, who helps run the forum, said, look, metformin is as natural as berberine. And while some effects of both overlap, the pleiotropic effects, in other words, all these extra mechanisms haven't really been studied as well as metformin. Tom's right, he's a smart guy. So what does the science actually say about berberine? Well, it said several things. This is one from a group of Eastern researchers. And in fact, there's been so much experience with it in the East. That's what you tend to see. Eastern researchers have done work on it. This is a meta-analysis. Berberine in the treatment of type 2 diabetes. A systemic review and meta-analysis. What did they find? Considerable statistical heterogeneity. In other words, the findings were not that consistent overall, but they did see several studies. The blood sugar impact or the blood glucose impact was the same as using oral prescription medications. Again, most often metformin. Speaking of mechanisms, what are the mechanisms? I'm gonna get again, dip into the technical side for just a minute. Not all of these are totally proven, but again, just a list of things that the geeks can think about. AMPK, activated protein kinase inhibitor. It enhances insulin sensitivity. That's the thing, the pattern that you see most often, enhancing sensitivity to insulin. So if it does that, you're gonna get a reduced weight gain for people with insulin resistance. You'll get a decreased hemoglobin A1C. You get decreased fasting insulin. It doesn't really appear to impact insulin secretion in and of itself. It, again, appears to impact the response to the insulin. Therefore, maybe some protection of the islet cells. You know, when you're banging too hard and requiring too much insulin for too long, it wears them out. This gives them a rest. And as you might expect, with anything that improves blood sugar, you're gonna get an improvement in triglycerides. So, berberine go or no go? I use it. Like we've said, some sources say it's as effective as metformin. Ian and Associates in that August 2012 survey showed that it decreased hemoglobin A1C 1 to 2 points. As you know, there'll always be debate. Other sources say it's unproven. I don't think it's unproven. I think there's still debate. There will always be debate. In terms of cost, you know, some metformins are being given away free just to get you to come into the pharmacy. So making the case that it costs less, I think is a little bit of a shaky debate. If you are taking it, how much do you take? 900 to 1500 milligrams daily. Now, most people take it once daily, but the half-life is 4.5 hours. So if you, a lot of people would say, well, you better take it twice a day or even 3 times a day. That statement's assuming that fluctuation in blood level of berberine is a bad thing. And that's an assumption too. So overall, is there science behind it? Yep, there's some science behind it. Is it conclusive? It's strong, but it's not conclusive. What do I do? I use it. Thank you for your interest.